So what the heck did the Niners do this offseason? I'll tell you. But in order to get a full understanding, let's start at the end of last season. The Niners finished with a 4-12 record. Disappointing is an understatement, but the injuries were the key reasons why the record was what it was. Let's start from the top. Jimmy G got hurt in the week 3 matchup against the Kansas City Chiefs. Before the season could start, Jerick McKinnon tore his ACL, and that was just the beginning. Adrian Colbert's season was cut short because of a high ankle sprain. Matt Breida played hurt through the majority of the season, also with ankle problems. Marquise Goodwin missed 3 games, but also played hurt for the majority of the year. Raheem Mostert missed half the year after breaking his arm against the Raiders. Dante Pettis missed some games, also in the middle of the season and the last game of the season due to knee injury. Tart missed half the games with a shoulder injury. Trent Taylor missed games with a back injury. Jimmy Ward, please don't even get me started with him. Malcolm Smith missed about 4 games. Akello Witherspoon and Quan both missed a couple games due to knee injuries, and even veteran Richard Sherman missed some games due to his injury as well. You mix in some aches and bruises in there, and I'm surprised the Niners can finish the season out. But coffee break, if everyone got hurt, who didn't? Well, as we all know, with football comes injuries, no doubt about that, but there were some folks who had a record-breaking season. George Kittle stands out, Mike McGlinchey had a hell of a rookie season, Joe Staley was just the stud he is at left tackle, we saw what Nick Mullins could do, Richard Sherman, even though he missed some time, looked like a nice addition to this young secondary. I love Bourne's play at wide receiver, made some big plays for us. Fred Warner snatched that linebacker position and never looked back. That made me feel a little better with the Reuben Foster situation lingering in the background. Glad that's over with though. And the play from Buckner at defensive line was just awesome. So there were a lot of positives to go around with everything happening around them. Let's see how that shaped up the offseason moves though. They re-signed Mike Person to keep this offensive line unit intact. Franchise tagged the kicker Robbie Gould, but not because he wants to be here, but more so because the Niners want him here. Come on, Robbie. We need you here, man. Traded for D Ford and drafted my boy Nick Bosa. Much needed help at edge rusher. We let go of Brock Coyle, but replaced him with Quan Alexander. We did re-sign Jimmy Ward, but also brought in a very great cornerback when healthy, Jason Barrett. Brought in Tevin Coleman to go along with Breida and the Jet. We let go of Pierre Garçon, but we did pick 2 very talented receivers in the draft, Jalen Hurd, but also the one I'm most excited about, Deebo Samuel. And there it is, guys. You subtract some guys and you add some folks who you think will help this team, and you are looking at a new and improved 49ers team, especially on the offensive side of the ball. It is loaded with talent everywhere. I'm curious though about this defense. How will Saleh use this defensive line group to get the most out of them? Because defensive line is the most talented group on the defensive side of the ball, so I expect them to dominate every game. My favorite signing is running back Tevin Coleman. I think this is a perfect situation for both parties. He knows the system and he plays it very well. My favorite draft pick is Deebo Samuel this year. Can't wait to see him and Jimmy G this season. It's going to be fun, Niner fans. I think we're going to be scoring a lot of points. But I'd like to hear your thoughts about the 49ers offseason as a whole. How do you think we did? We are less than 2 months away from the preseason. I can't wait until football season, guys. I need this bad boy to start soon. I'll be excited to watch some videos of practice to see how guys are shaping up. Remember, don't get carried away. It's just practice. We've done it before. Let these guys play it out, and we'll see how this depth chart moves as the season progresses. Thank you all for watching, and as always, we will see you on the next one, guys. Peace.